So, Laetae Omnes. Today we're looking at Book 5, Section 29. Okay, so we have Titurius Sabinus was shouting that they, and then what's understood as Eos. So, this is he's speaking against Cotta and his guys, soldiers, the idea that's to stay in camp. He wants to get the, wants the Romans to leave. So, he was shouting that they would do these things, this is Facturus essay, would do these things too late. After a maiores magnus, a great band of enemies, had joined or had come together to the joined Germans. Alright, so it's too late after the Germans had come and joined them. Or when another calamity, literally another of a calamity, this is a partitive genitive, had been received or had happened, even you could say, in the nearby winter camps. Alright? And then he says, Breviam consulem esse occasium. So, that we're continuing the indirect statement. So, Titurius said that short or brief was the opportunity, and this is a gerund, and it's in the genitive. So, brief was the opportunity or the occasion of consulting. So, they only have a short time to figure out what to do. And then, this next little trick. On line 4 is a little tricky here. Okay? And he goes and says, Caesarem arbitrari. What you want to go ahead and put in here is say. A lot of times say is left out of these indirect statements here. So say, he thought that Caesar had profectum esse. This is from proficiscor, to set out. Had set out into Italy. So he says, well, so he thinks that Caesar's gone. Okay, nor, and this is his reasoning, nor otherwise. And this is a, we have here fuisse, which is the infinitive of sum with capturus. This is the past contrary to fact in indirect statements. So you use fuisse and capturus to get that pluperfect subjunctive. Nor otherwise. Would have the Carnutes, adopted a plan of, and this is a gerunda phrase, of killing Tasgentius, nor the Abrones, if he were present, if Caesar were present, would the Abrones had come to our camp, to the camp, with so great, this is an ablative going contemptione, with such a great contempt for us. And that's a objective genitive. All right. And then we're going to keep moving down here. And then we have here, non hostem actorum, said rem spectare. He, and I would put, go ahead and put he in here, meaning Sabinius. He does not see an enemy author of the plan. So he does not see the enemy author, but he sees the matter. That's how I would go with it. I don't really like the way I do it, but you can look it up and think about it for yourself. But he sees the matter at hand. So he sees how it really is. Okay? The Rhine, Sabiese, all indirect statement. So the Rhine is near. Okay? And then this is our accusative subject in the next sentence. Mortem. And superiores victores nostras. So the death of Ariovistus is from Book 1, and, or he didn't die in Book 1, but that's when he was defeated. So the death of Ariovistus and our earlier victories were esse, and we get a double dative here, okay? We have a dative of purpose, dolore, with a dative of reference with the Germans. So the death of Ariovistus and our earlier victories were, for the Germans, a great pain or great grief. Okay, Gaul is inflamed, so is inflamed with revolt. Okay, is inflamed it or wasn't is Gaul was inflamed. Okay, with so many contumeles, so many insults having been received, or so many injuries. And this is an ablative absolute. Okay? And I will not go ahead and put an and in. This is really a great doctum, a PPP going with Galliam, but I would go ahead and put an and in rather than translate. This sounds a little bit better. And they had been driven back under the power of the Roman people. So they had been, they're under the control of the Roman people, they're saying. And then we have another ablative absolute here at the end. With the early glory of military thing having been destroyed. So with their earlier glory in military, the early glory of the army, of the military, having been destroyed. All right. So you're saying the Gauls are, there we go. So we're almost there. We're going to look here at finally. Okay, then we have Postrema quis hoc sibi persuaderet. Okay, so we have, so finally, who would persuade themselves of this? Okay. So who would persuade them? So who would persuade themselves of this? This is the dative going persuadit, and this is the object of what you're persuading. Okay. So who would persuade them of this? So without a certain cause, ambiorix, that, okay, and this is that, sorry, indirect statement, that, without certain cause, ambiorix had descended to a plan of this type. So why would he adopt, why would he try to, like, go after the Romans? No. Okay? He's saying, ambiorix is our friend. Why would he adopt a plan that would, you know, that's going to harm us, he's trying to say. And we have here, he says, sua sententia in utrum partem esse tutum. Okay, in both parts, in each part, so each alternative, we could say, so in each, for each alternative, his opinion is safe. If there was nothing more difficult, there's nothing more harsh, so there's nothing bad going on, then they would come, indirect statement, they would come with no danger to a nearby legion. So if everything was working out okay, then they just get there and be with their buddies. If all of all were agreeing or were allied with the Germans, then our only safety has been placed in speed. Okay? Almost done here. And then we got here. Okay, indeed, aqua am. So these are genus, hata and aphora. Okay? Indeed, what outcome does the plan of Cotta and those who disagree, okay, in which, if there is not the present danger, if we still are here, but certainly hunger must be feared in a long siege. All right, we'll make sure to go over this tomorrow. If you have any questions, please talk to me. Volete omnes lingua latina est vita.